Hello everyone. So in this lecture I'm going to explain you about modulation index, power relations and frequency spectrum of amplitude modulated wave. In this regard I'm going to explain you first modulation index. So what is modulation index? It is nothing but a ratio between the amplitude of massless wave and the amplitude of carrier wave, and mathematically it is given as m is equal to vm by VC. It is also known as modulation factor, modulation coefficient, degree of modulation, depth of modulation, or sometimes percent of modulations. See here, I have shown you AM wave, and there are certain things which I am going to explain you about. And this is basically okay. So look at here. This is the AM wave, and here this is the value of V max. This is V max from here to here. This is the V max. This point is from here to here. I can show you from this point to this point. This is the V minimum, which is the lowest value of amplitudes. This AM signal. Vm is this one, that means total from here to here, this is the 2 Vm value, massive signal amplitude double of this, and this value is Vm, this portion is, look at here, this is the Vm, this part or the below part. Vc is that amplitude of AC signal, carrier signal is nothing but this is, this portion from here to here, okay. So from this waveform, if I need to find out the derive the modulation index, how we can. So if the original amplitude of carrier wave and massless wave is denoted by Vc and Vm respectively, then the maximum amplitude V max will be what? Vc plus Vm. Look at here. This V max is equal to from here to here. If I am going to add this Vc and plus this Vm, so this is nothing but total Vc plus Vm. Similarly, V min minus is equal to Vc minus Vm. So V minimum, this is the V minimum portion. And if I am subtracting this Vc from here to here and minus this Vm, this portion from here to here, so we can get this V minimum value. Okay. So this two we can, V max and V minimum is okay. Now, if you need to find out Vm, that means massive signal amplitude, then this amplitude Vm, yeah, this Vm. So what I'll do, this V maximum minus V minimum, what will get? This value from here to here, and this value is equal to what? Equal to 2 Vm. You can look it out here. This is equal to nothing but 2 Vm. So it means that if Vm is equal to what? V max minus V min divided by 2. So V max minus V min divided by 2 is equal to Vm. And if you need to find out Vc, so this is the Vc, this portion from here to here, from here to here is Vc, this portion. So it, what will do, from V max, if I subtract this V minimum, Vm, this V max, if I am going to subtract this Vm, what will get? I will get this Vc. So the same thing I have done, from V max I have subtracted Vm, and I have got V max value, and I substitute this value of Vm here, V max minus V min divided by 2, I will get the value V max plus V min by 2. So in this equation, M is equal to Vm by Vc. In this equation, we substitute the value of Vm and Vc, and this is the derivation of modulation index in terms of maximum and minimum amplitude. So in, we have to simple, it is a observation that the carrier wave amplitude should be higher than the amplitude of massless wave, but that's not the compulsory, but it should be. Now frequency spectrum, when we come to the frequency spectrum, so what we know that there is a three term in the amplitude modulated wave, and these three terms are carrier, this is which is upper sideband, fc plus fm, lower sideband fc minus fm. And the magnitude is, as we know that we have derived the magnitude ma vc by 2. If I substitute the value of ma, that is nothing but vm by vc. So I can get the amplitude vm by 2. So the amplitude is either vm by 2 you can put, or ma vc by 2, both are the same in the case of lower sideband and upper sideband. So there are only three frequency term. One is for lower sideband, another is for higher sideband, and the third one is for carrier frequency. Similarly, the magnitude of lower sideband, magnitude of higher sideband, and magnitude of this one. If I need to find out the bandwidth, so what is the formula for bandwidth? Higher frequency minus lower frequency. So fc plus fm minus fc minus fm, if I subtracted, I got the 2 into frequency of massive signal or modulating signal. So here you can see that there is no use of carrier signal, there is no carrier frequency involved here in the bandwidth also, isn't it? The same thing I mentioned here, the carrier is having highest amplitude, USB, LSB, and the double sideband bandwidth, double of this one. And it is also called DSB LC or DSB FC, full carrier. The power relations in M, the power actually, it contains three terms, that means carrier, lower sideband, and upper sideband. So the formula is nothing but V square by R. Here this V is nothing but amplitude, and all the three terms, all the three values of V are nothing but RMS value. Okay, so the amplitude which we have received is amplitude should be divided by root 2 and then put it here. So carrier amplitude is what? Vc by carrier amplitude is Vc. I just go back little bit. Carrier amplitude is Vc here. Masses amplitude is Vm by 2. So just divide by root 2 and then square it out. So carrier of power is equal to Vc square by 2R, that means Vc divided by root 2 square divided by R. You can see, check it out here. This I have converted into the RMS value, and we got Vc square by 2R, the power of carrier signal. Similarly, lower sideband and upper sideband power is equal to MVc by 2, that is nothing but amplitude of lower sideband and upper sideband divided by root 2, which is equal to MVc square by 8R. And substitute this value in this equation, what will get? Vc square by 2R, ma Vc square by 4 into 2R, ma Vc square divided by 4 into 2R. Vc square by 2R will be common factor here, you can check it out, isn't it? And 1 plus ma square by 4 plus 1 plus ma square by 4. So the total power will be, in the terms of carrier, it can write it, we can add this one as a pc, 1 plus m square by 2. And here the p in the terms of relation with pm by pc is equal to 1 plus m square by 2, or pam is equal to pc into 1 plus m square by 2. If I need to find the total power power in sidebands, so add both the sidebands, plsb plus pusb. And if you are adding this total m square vc square by 8r plus m square vc by square by 8r, you just add this both, you will be getting m square vc square by 4r, which is nothing but taking vc square by 2r as a common, so pc into m square by 2. Similarly, if you need to find out the side power of the side bands in single sideband, so you just take any one, PLSB or PUSB, which is equal to m square vc square by 8r, or take vc square by 2r as a common, which will be equal to pc into m square by 4. So three power which we have find out, total is equal to this one, pm is equal to pc into 1 plus m square by 2. Second power is equal to pc into m square by 2, this is total sideband powers, and this is the single sideband power is equal to pc into m square by 4, isn't it? And the last term is transmission efficiency. The transmission efficiency is defined as the sum of sideband powers divided by total power. So sum of sideband powers is equal to plsb plus pusb divided by p total, and which is nothing but pc into ma square by 2 divided by pc into 1 plus ma square by 2, which is equal to ma square divided by 2 plus ma square. In the terms of percentage is equal to ma square divided by 2 plus ma square into 100, and this is the